All right, so today I have a video for you because I want to share this with you and the world out there. As someone who's born deaf in one ear and who has tinnitus and a hearing aid in his remaining right ear for the last 15 years. But first of all, before I share with you why I do believe that habituation can be a cure for tinnitus so that you are no longer bothered by your tinnitus, you are no longer stressed out and negatively affected by your tinnitus, I want to say this. If you don't believe in habituation, if you don't believe that you can cure all the negativity that you experience in relationship to your tinnitus without curing tinnitus itself, then you should go on buying ridiculous herbal remedies that use AI figures of Keanu Reeves, etc. But this is not the channel for you. I also have to say that immediately, I'm not going to waste my time and energy anymore for people who put negative comments under my videos, to which I devote a lot of work and effort and sharing what I have learned over the past 5 years of working with 500 plus people with tinnitus. So if this is something that you're thinking about, I'm just going to delete your comment. I'm not even going to read it. So if you don't believe in this, then this is not the channel for you. This is the first thing I want to say. And after that, I want to say welcome to another video here on my tinnitus channel, on my tinnitus habituation channel, where I, Frida, share my experience with having coached so many people and having built an online tinnitus program at MyTinnitus.club. And today in this video, I want to share with you a little bit more on why I believe that tinnitus habituation can definitely be a cure for tinnitus and definitely cure you of all negative emotions around your tinnitus and therefore be a tool that helps you to get your tinnitus where it belongs, namely in the background. So without further ado, enjoy this video. And if you don't believe in any of it, don't stay on this channel. Don't waste my time. Don't waste your time. But for the rest, welcome and let's jump in. So here's the thing. Many people still believe that there is a once and for all kind of approach and solution to tinnitus, and it lies in the nature of tinnitus, however, that that is not true at all. Many people deal with different forms of tinnitus, be it somatic, so from neck and back issues, or hearing loss based tinnitus, meaning that you rack up a hearing loss like I did together with my hearing aid, and therefore your brain interprets the missing sound as a tinnitus. And the thing about tinnitus, though, is that for people who are habituated to tinnitus, meaning that they have no negative reaction about tinnitus at all, their brain has understood that their tinnitus is not posing a threat on their quality of life anymore. That means that they experience tinnitus, but they are not bothered by it, meaning that the symptomatic experience of tinnitus, right, so that they hear a tone that no one else can hear, is still 100% there, but they do not react to it. Sometimes that tinnitus might be worse, sometimes might be higher intensity, sometimes might be lower in intensity, but they know that they don't have to attach any meaning to these changes in intensity of their tinnitus. And this is one of the most important things that I have found out in the last 5 years of working with 500 plus people with tinnitus in coaching sessions and also what we teach inside our habituation program, that habituation is a once and for all approach for you to stop being bothered by your tinnitus, right? You can shift from bothersome to non-bothersome tinnitus, because when your brain starts to understand that you don't need to react to tinnitus in this way and that it is a safe and benign body sensation that you're actually experiencing, then tinnitus can go into the background, much like you have not categorized your fridge humming in the background as something dangerous, right? And it's quite likely that because of the experience that you had with tinnitus, maybe insomnia, maybe severe anxiety, being really stressed out about your tinnitus, it's quite natural that your brain continues to want to try to avoid this pain and want to avoid that you have a terrible and difficult time with your tinnitus. Therefore, it's always constantly looking for the tinnitus, because surely enough, if this has caused you this much pain and difficulty, then it's very important that we continuously try to establish control over it. And then the negative outcome from that is that you continuously try to control your tinnitus, and then your brain tries to do what it does all the time when we say, okay, I went to the supermarket to buy butter. Did I buy butter? Yes, I bought butter. So was it successful? Yes, it was successful. Moving on to the next problem. The tinnitus problem is another one. Your brain is like, okay, I got upset about tinnitus. I activated the fight or flight response. I got anxious. Did it solve my tinnitus problem? And then you stop, you listen, your tinnitus is still there. Your anxiety is still there. So the brain says, well, we still have this problem. Therefore, your brain cannot start to habituate to tinnitus. Habituating to tinnitus means that the brain learns to classify tinnitus as a benign body sensation that we don't need to get into. And if we do have some anxiety and negative feelings about that, we can learn to completely change this reaction, build a different habit that turns into habituation, where the brain understands that tuning into this is not necessary. And it's the same thing that if I believe most people have experienced already, that they were doing something they were fully engaged in, something, a sports, an activity, something that's fun to you, and you didn't even notice that your tinnitus was there. And that is something that can extend over the whole period of time if your brain understands that tinnitus is not something that it has to watch as a danger in your background, because that's what our brain does. That's what our ears do. If there's a sound categorized as a danger, it can't stop hearing that sound, right? That's natural survival instinct. If you lie on the campsite at night and there's a sound that you are not familiar with and it's potentially threatening, this defines your survival or your demise. And in the same way that if tinnitus is something that you're constantly worried about and have built such a negative relationship with, it's impossible for your brain to start classifying it as not more than the humming of your fridge in the background. It's also normal that you become severely reactive and severely emotional and have big anxiety and difficulties when tinnitus becomes louder and it spikes, etc. So what I'm saying is that, of course, you should go see your ENT, physiotherapist, work with your TMJ, etc. But if I can tell you that all of these things can still be in your normal somatic experience, so the change of tinnitus with tiredness levels, when we drink alcohol or other things, that can always change and it can continuously change, and that will continue to be that way. And how you react and respond to that is going to tell your brain whether you're safe or whether you have to run away in flight and continue to fight this with all your resources and continuously being focused on it. And if you achieve the state of habituation, which is not a quick one-day fix or a quick protocol, but it's something that you build over weeks and months, which we have designed the product for, then that is absolutely, and there are videos on this on my YouTube channel, and I've made podcast episodes about this. I think it is like a tinnitus cure. I have tinnitus. I'm not bothered by it one bit. The people I've worked with, they experience tinnitus, but they're not bothered by their tinnitus anymore. So the state of habituation is like a tinnitus cure, because in the end, you stop being bothered by your tinnitus. And it doesn't matter anymore whether you have tinnitus or not. I hope this was useful. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope it made the concept of habituation a little bit clearer and that it can support you. All right, see you in the next one. Bye-bye.
All right, guys, I just wanted to give you a very short introduction here to our online Tinnitus Club. So as soon as you have signed up, and I'll show you in a minute how to easily do that, you are directed onto this very first page. It's a quick welcome video where I tell you a little bit more about this club and everything that we have in store for you. We have a challenge going on to help everyone building the right kind of habits towards being able to habituate to their tinnitus. You can see there's a lot of engagement. And down here, you will see the tinnitus courses. So when you go down here, you can find the beginner's course that's included in all of these subscriptions. You would go to www.mytinnitus.club, and then you go to choose a plan, and then down here you will find all the different plans. So for example, if you want unlimited access to everything for 7 days to try everything out, then you can just get the 7-day plan for $9.99. Access to everything, enter your first name, last name, email and password, and you create your account. Quickly put your credit card data in. It's all safe and secure. This is handled by the platform and Stripe. So it's all safe and secure, or you can log in with Google, Facebook, LinkedIn, or Apple. For the other ones, we have 14-day free trials. So if you want to check those out, you get 14-day trials on any of these packages. Continue with Apple, and then just agree to these terms and conditions, and then you're set to join our online Tinnitus Club.